Hi, I'm Tim Kilbourn from the Android Framework team, and I want to talk about building great apps for Android TV. Android TV apps are developed using all the familiar components and tools from the Android Framework. So if you already have a great phone or tablet app, you're on your way to bringing that experience to the big screen. However, there are some key differences between developing for a phone or a tablet and a TV. In particular, the information density on a TV should be much lower than on a phone or a tablet. No one wants to read a wall of text on a TV. Also, the way we interact with the TV is through a D-pad, like a remote controller or game controller, rather than touch. So make sure all of the important elements of your app are focusable. Let's look at an example of an app written for Android TV. This app uses minimal amounts of text, and everything is reachable with a D-pad. Navigating to find something to watch is easy with these layouts. In fact, because this browsing concept is so common for a TV app, we've built a new support library to help you create beautiful, easy-to-use apps for the big screen. By using the widgets and fragments from this Leanback support library, you will be able to quickly create apps that work well on TVs. The Leanback support library is based on the model view presenter pattern. We've made it straightforward to separate the way you display your content from the model objects you use to store the data. The model objects come from your app. We don't put any requirements on them, so it should be possible to update an existing app to run on a TV without changing your model. The views are the standard Android views that you know and love, like text views and image views and so on. What's new for Android in this library is the presenter. Given a model object, the presenter binds the data from that object to a view that the library code can use to display your items in all the screens of your app. In particular, the same item can be rendered in different ways in different parts of your app simply by replacing the presenter. Let's look at some examples. Here we have a screen that lets the user browse through a content catalog. This is implemented using a browse fragment from the Leanback support library. The fragment is instantiated and given an object adapter that contains the model objects and the presenters used to render them. The library code in the fragment takes care of the rest, calling the methods in the presenters for each item to show the views in the rows. Next, we have a details screen. The same model object that was previously rendered using a small card view can now be rendered to show more details simply by using a different presenter. We also see rows of related content below the details overview, with presenters creating each of those views as well. In-app search works in the same way. Your app will receive the text of the query as the user enters it, and the search fragment uses the object adapter and presenters that you provide to show the results. There are a few other things you'll want to do to make your app look great on a TV. We've designed a new launcher that's optimized for getting you into the content you want to see as quickly as possible, and that starts with content recommendations. Using the existing Android Notifications API, your app can publish recommendations for videos or other content that viewers will want to see next. You specify the data, including the card image and the text, and the launcher will show the recommendations prominently on the home screen. The order of all these recommendations is determined by how the user interacts with them, so make sure you're creating high-quality recommendations that will make people want to return to your app. You can find more details and sample code for presenters, fragments, and content recommendations on the new developer site for Android TV. Thanks for watching. Now go make some great TV apps.